Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about kidney stones, also called renal calculi nephrolithiasis or urolithiasis, are hard deposits made of minerals and salts that form inside your kidneys. Diet, excess body weight, some medical conditions, and certain supplements and medications are among the many causes of kidney stones. Kidney stones can affect any part of your urinary tract from your kidneys to your bladder. Often, stones form when the urine becomes concentrated, allowing minerals to crystallize and stick together. Passing kidney stones can be quite painful, but the stones usually cause no permanent damage if they're recognized in a timely fashion. Depending on your situation, you may need nothing more than to take pain medication and drink lots of water to pass a kidney stone. In other instances, for example, if stones become lodged in the urinary tract, are associated with a urinary infection, or cause complications, surgery may be needed. Your doctor may recommend preventive treatment to reduce your risk of recurrent kidney stones if you're at increased risk of developing them again. There are four main types of stones. Calcium oxalate, the most common type of kidney stone, which is created when calcium combines with oxalate in the urine. Inadequate calcium and fluid intake, as well as other conditions, may contribute to their formation. Uric acid, this is another common type of kidney stone. Foods such as organ meats and shellfish have high concentrations of a natural chemical compound known as purines. High purine intake leads to a higher production of monosodium urate, which, under the right conditions, may form stones in the kidneys. The formation of these types of stones tends to run in families. 3. Struvite. Struvite stones are less common than calcium and uric stones. Struvite stones can happen when bacteria from upper urinary tract infections get into your urinary tractae. 4. Cysteine. These stones are rare and tend to run in families. They are caused by a rare condition called cystinuria that is passed down in families. Cystinuria causes a natural chemical called cysteine to leak into your urine. When there is too much cysteine in your urine, kidney stones can form. These stones can get stuck in your kidneys, bladder, or anywhere in your urinary tract. Most people with cystinuria will get many stones in their life. It is a lifelong condition that can be treated but not cured. What are the causes and risk factors of kidney stones? Anyone can get a kidney stone, but some people are more likely than others to get them. Men get kidney stones more often than women. Kidney stones are also more common in non-Hispanic white people than in people of other ethnicities. You may also be more likely to get a kidney stone if you 1. Have had kidney stones before 2. Have someone in your family with kidney stones 3. Do not drink enough water 4. Eat a lot of protein, sodium, salt, or sugar 5. Are overweight 6. Have had a surgery on your intestines 7. Have polycystic kidney disease 8. Have a health problem that causes your urine to contain high levels of cysteine, oxalate, uric acid, or calcium 9. Have a health problem that causes swelling or damage in your digestive system or your joints 10. Take certain medicines such as diuretics, water pills, or calcium-based antacids. What are the symptoms of kidney stones? If you have a small kidney stone, it may travel out of your body through your urine, called passing a kidney stone. You may not have any symptoms and may never know that you had a kidney stone. If you have a larger kidney stone, it may get stuck in your urinary tract and block urine from getting through. You may notice symptoms, including 1. Have blood in your urine 2. Feel sick 3. Vomit 4. Have a fever, hot and cold shivers or sweats 5. Feel like you have gravel in your urine 6. Feel like you need to pass urine often or urgently. You may feel a lot of pain when you pass a kidney stone or if a large kidney stone blocks the flow of your urine. If you're having any of these symptoms, please contact your doctor. How long does it take to pass the kidney stone? The amount of time that it takes to pass a kidney stone can vary depending on the size of the stone. Generally, small stones are able to pass through the urine within 1-2 weeks, often without any treatment. On the other hand, larger stones may take 2-3 weeks to move through the kidneys and into the bladder. Stones that don't pass on their own within 4 weeks typically require medical treatment. How to prevent kidney stones? Proper hydration is a key preventive measure. It's recommended to drink enough fluid to pass at least 2.5 liters of urine each day. Increasing the amount of urine you pass helps flush the kidneys. How are kidney stones diagnosed? Your healthcare provider will discuss your medical history and possibly order some tests. These tests include 1. Imaging tests, an x-ray, CT scan, and ultrasound will help your healthcare provider see the size, shape, location, and number of your kidney stones. These tests help your provider decide what treatment you need. 2. Blood test. A blood test will reveal how well your kidneys are functioning, check for infection, and look for biochemical problems that may lead to kidney stones. 3. Urine test. This test also looks for signs of infection and examines the levels of the substances that form kidney stones. You can reduce the risk of getting a kidney stone by drinking plenty of water, limiting drinks that contain phosphoric acid, which may be used to flavor cola and beer, avoiding urinary tract infections, and if you get one, treating it quickly, limiting your intake of animal protein, such as red meat chicken, seafood and eggs. Drinking fruit juices, especially orange, grapefruit, and cranberry, including dairy foods or alternatives in your diet, reducing your salt intake. If you have had a stone before, your doctor may advise you about additional treatments to help you avoid getting another one. We have come to the end of this video. I hope it was helpful to you, and if you liked this video, please consider subscribing to my channel so that you can watch more videos like this to share with family and friends. At the same time, you will help the channel grow and motivate me to make more helpful videos.